Well, hello, Internet. Welcome back to our ongoing series on Azure ML. Today, we'll cover a number of topics on Azure ML, including how to do data exploration, as well as data visualization tools at your disposal in Azure ML. So if you've been with us since the beginning, you know that we'll be working with the Titanic Data Set. If you don't know how we got the Titanic Data Set, please go watch one of our previous videos. I will link it below or on the screen. All right, so let's actually just get started. So I have my machine learning already open. You want to go to click on Save Data and then find your Titanic data set and just drag that in. And that's kind of cool, right? So the entirety of the table that it represents the Titanic data set is represented by a visual object, kind of like a Visio box. And if you right click on it or left click on it, you can either download the data to a text file or whatever you want, or you can visualize it. So you can actually take a quick peek snapshot of what's inside the data. And so you can preview the first 100 rows inside of the data itself. However, if you will notice at the very top, it says there's 890 rows present within the entirety of the data. So it's just a quick preview to basically show you what you're dealing with in the data. So it helps with data exploration because you really have to understand your data before you can start modeling it and start mining it. Okay, so let's see how we will approach data exploration using Azure ML. So let's start with the columns. All right, so there's 12 columns. Hold on just a second. All right, so there's 12 columns total. And let's see what each of them are. So the passenger ID is basically the primary key of this database. So it may not matter in the grand scheme of things. So we might note that this can be removed later. Survived, that's our response class. So that's gonna be what we're trying to predict. We're trying to create a model to predict whether or not they will survive based upon these other attributes, right? Let's see, P class represents the passenger class. So that's first class, second class, third class. Sex, that's a given. Name, that's also a given. Age, oh, there's some actually really interesting things to look at for age. So you will notice that age actually has a bunch of stats associated with because it is numeric. So let's take a look at that. So the median age on the Titanic was 29, so about 30 years old. And the youngest person on the Titanic was about 40.42 years old. So he's about 5 months old. It's a baby. The maximum is 80. So that means the oldest person on the Titanic was 80 years old. That's kind of cool. And then SIB SP, I think that's a really bad name for a column. It stands for the number of siblings and spouses, so it's the combined count of the number of siblings and spouse that went with you into the Titanic. And then PARCH is also a really bad name for a column, but it represents parent and child. So how big was basically your immediate family that you were traveling with? And then ticket, I'm not sure how relevant that's gonna be because it's basically just your ticket number. And then we have fare, how much did they pay for their fare, which could be an indicator of wealth combined with P class. And then you have your cabin number, which may or may not be important. And then you have embarked. Embarked is the city that they left from. As you can see, there's four different unique values, which keep in mind, NA is also, or null is also included as a unique value. So that means really there's really three unique values. So I'm just gonna take a look at the key for what each of them means. And I have got it from the source itself. This is on the Kaggle website. They've given a key to which each of them means. And then C under embark means Schoenberg. Q is Queenstown and S is Southampton. So that just basically represents what town the Titanic got the passenger from. You can also get a good feel for the distribution of your data just by looking at the histograms provided above the stats, right? So we can click on that and see that there was a lot more male than female that were on the ship. And if you click on age, for example, you can actually see that there was a huge influx of the younger generation. And you can also convert between histogram and box plots. So you can see that the median age was 29, and there are some few outliers right above here. So Azure ML will actually let you compare distributions as well, right? And then let's go to sex, for example, and let's compare sex to their age. So judging from these two box plots, you can tell that the males that were on the Titanic were slightly older than the females. right? And then you can actually use some really cool things here, right? So you can actually go click on this button to take a snapshot of this distribution. So I'm just going to do that, click on that, and then it'll move it to the side. So now you can actually compare two different distributions against each other. So let's compare, for example, sex to fair price. All right, and as you can tell by the scale, this looks hideous. You can barely tell what's happening in this picture. But if you click on scales and then you check the box fair, it will actually log it for you. So you can see the scale a lot easier. So you can actually see from these two box plots that females actually pay much higher on average than males did. All right, so let's see whether or not being male or female had anything to do with whether or not they lived or died. So let's see that. So let's change fair to survive. So let's compare sex to survived. And you will notice that it breaks. And I'll let you know why it broke. So let's scroll down and actually just take a look at that. You will notice that survived is actually listed as a numeric type. And it's not what it should be, which is categorical typing. You also notice that P class should also be categorical too, but it's classified as numeric. Embarked is also a string, which also should be categorical. So there's a bunch of things in this data set that's actually miscasted. And this is true for things like R as well. You have to cast your data before you can actually start using it correctly. And that actually leads into the next topic, which is pre-processing of data. So join us next time when I will go over how to pre-process data using Azure ML.
If you like what you just saw, subscribe to our channel or leave us a comment. Let us know if there's a topic you want us to cover, and be sure to check us out at datasciencedojo.com. Until next time.